Bring bedding ding do do ba do bum bum. I need to go to the other channel, cause if I don't, I won't be able to see if it's all good. I need to turn down my stuff a lot more, cause it's very sensitive. Oh, it sounds better. That's how I know it's too loud.
What will it take just to find a special day?
There we go, it improved a lot more right when I turned that down a little bit.
Oh shit, man.
That's good.
Shut up, you're overlaying it, crap. Not you, me.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I can put the context together.
Ooh, turn down that and then turn up that. Okay. Hello, everybody. Welcome on back to another beautiful, beautiful episode of Doki Doki Literature Club. We tried streaming a little bit of Link to the Past 3, and man, that game is... It's really selling itself. It's really doing itself wonders for our experience with it so far. But, we're gonna ignore that. We're gonna forget that. Zelda isn't real right now. And we are just going to play something that is definitely real. Women. Simulator literature.
Women are...
Real? Question mark?
These ones, these ones are real.
Yeah! So we're gonna load up our game, and we are actually going to go on our date with Matt Supaki. And this is actually gonna be the very first time I actually see someone, or ourselves, or anyone go the Natsuki route, so. It's gonna be fun! And actually, wait. Until a little bit later, I don't even need to do any reading, because it's just you and Natsuki. All right.
I spent only a few minutes back at home anxiously waiting Natsuku's revival.
Revival.
Before I know it, she texts me to let me know she's out in the front.
She texted with like 20 emojis.
She texted me to let me know she's sniffing my grass.
She texted me to let me know that her dad still sucks. Who could have guessed?
He still beats me!
Really?
We've upgraded from spatula to belt! Wow!
I'm so lucky!
Look at all these marks!
Oh my god! Look at which character development I'm getting!
Oh my god.
It's funny seeing the patterns change on my face.
It's funny to see how used to it I get!
Man, my pain tolerance is fucking right up there!
Through the roof!
Might as well be a masochist!
Holy
Without delay, I open up the front door to let her in. Hi.
Sup!
Yeah, sup of all things.
Hey.
Hey.
I don't know what I was expecting, but... Why the fuck does she need a bra?
What does she need to hold, huh?
But seeing Natsuki in something other than her school uniform totally threw me off.
Especially seeing a fucking kitty on her titty.
it threw me off, and it soaked me off.
I'm sorry.
What?
Huh?
Seeing her such a into clothes makes the uniform seem totally unfitting in comparison.
Yeah.
Jeez, dude, make it feel awkward already.
Wait, yeah, I was about
You're
to say
the one
I
who
wasn't...
said sup question mark.
Sup. Yeah, you opened with sup. You ruined it from the start.
You opened with sup.
Sup. Sup, home slice.
It's good. What up? We finna bake some cookies.
Discord messed up for a second. So when you said bake, it like bleh, ate some cookies.
We finna bake.
Oh god.
You gotta go wild and you ready to tweak?
We're gonna tweak while we.
We tweaking while we baking.
We tweak while we. But what rhymes with tweak, but is also a baking thing? I don't fucking know. It's long. It's gonna be a long afternoon. Cause I'm gonna stay here even after we're done making cookies so that we can watch Netflix squeak. And just vibe.
Bleak. Bleak. Fucking. Schmeek. Whatever.
Speak. Anyway, I'm coming in. That's what.
Welcome. It said?
I see you brought a lot of stuff. My voice cracks sometimes.
No, yeah.
I love your bull setup.
She forgot this is my house.
I forgot. You were saying I love your bull sack. I swore that you were about to say, I love your bull sack. I was like, I'm sorry?
No, your bull sack.
You're all the bulls and their sacks.
Baka! Well, I didn't want to come all this way to find out that your kitchen isn't equipped for the job.
So I brought my whole kitchen instead.
I hope you're equipped for my job.
Wink, wink, wink.
You bought everything I asked you to, right?
That was $300 worth of stuff.
Okay, great! Yeah, just doesn't even care. Yeah, you're financially unstable. Okay, back to what I was talking about.
You have a job, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I freaking move the carts at Walmart.
Yeah, I'm a cart boy.
Pay $3 a cart moved.
Luckily today there was 300, but I got lucky.
I had to go a mile away from Target to find those carts that the homeless people take.
Yeah! I had to find one nearby, a pizza shop!
Honestly, that would be kind of fun if like, your manager's like, we have sightings of a Target cart at the east of this location.
Right.
Go hunt
it. Your job is to track it. Walk it back here. But beware.
The homeless are near.
Yeah.
The don't
homeless
let them
might
take
not
it.
Be too happy. I saw him throwing shit at cars passing by the freeway.
It was. So, I can like, tell you wasn't dog shit.
I've replayed Link to the Past a million times. I know how to dodge shit. Anyway.
I know how to start a game and not finish it. Don't worry.
I'll chop off his leg and then just leave him.
I'll give him a little.
Finish my jobs. Good luck with your healthcare.
Yeah, good luck. Good luck with your activism and patriotic duties.
Yeah, yesterday, Nancy asked me to buy a bunch of ingredients if I didn't already have them at home.
Good. Glad I can count on you to do your part.
And now I'm gonna steal all of it and leave you here. Goodbye!
Hey, that's what I came here for. I'm like that homeless guy that...
Yeah, I'm the homeless shopping cart man. Why else do you think I have this green snaggletooth?
You know that one shopping cart that you see 2 miles away from Target? That was me.
No, I did it.
I'm on the wanted posters! I'm on the Target hit list!
Yeah, I'm famous at Target!
They know me!
Yeah. Well, of course... Shut up. My nose is stuffy.
Okay.
I'm surprised to hear Natsuki suddenly say that, rather than something snarky like she usually does. Could it be that she's a little different outside of school after all?
Oh, just ask her dad. I bet he'll say she's different entirely.
Who the fuck left the sink on?
What?
It looks like the faucet's running a little bit. Never
mind. I can somewhat see it, yeah.
Anyway, let's go to the kitchen where the sink is left.
Oh, yeah, let's go to the kitchen, you know, where we're at right now.
Let's go to the kitchen. Just, like, step 1 foot over. Into the kitchen.
Yeah, here we are, the kitchen.
I can't tell if this is like a low-end Japanese home or like a high-end one.
That's that's a very good point. Yeah,
It looks like a $3 million home.
It does look very, yeah. It's well kept is also another thing as well. Who wouldn't want their bowls in their own cubbies? And their fucking toaster oven underneath their cabinets. And there's two ovens on top of one another. Right there. There, right where her arm is at, that's two different handles for the same fucking oven.
And then so, another one to the far right.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the toaster oven. Yeah, so it's just, I am a man that owns five ovens! That's a
pretty big toast to put in there. What, are you not even gonna offer to take this heavy shirt off of me?
No, just lift it up onto your curls.
Where's your hospitality, Pakawa?
Oh, I can put you, Pakawa.
Can I call you Kawa? Come on.
I'm not a boy, girl.
I'm not a leaf. I'm not a. What?
No. Toko Fukawa.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just fucking go to the next one.
I didn't know you read him, stupid.
What? I said come on, and I screamed it.
Oh, I thought you were like saying come on to like me for being stupid.
Yeah,
which,
that's just because my voice acting is good. Dumbass.
I was so in character that I was so out of character.
Since when did I need to be a gentleman? Sorry, that anger is directed at Bunkatron.
I'm sorry, my waifu. I didn't mean to speak to you like that, my sweetheart.
Like brushes your four fingers against
me. Yeah, brushes the hair out of her eyes. Like, I'm sorry, sweetheart. I didn't mean to speak to you like that.
I'm sorry, but you must be used to it with your dad. Anyway, I grab the bag Natsuki holds out to me. She like just fucking like...
Again!
She sets it on your hand and you just fucking drop to the ground.
You just do a fucking front flip. It's that heavy. It's like, come on, fucking work out more.
You do that anime thing where the sound effects are like, whoop,
whoop, whoop. Yeah, whoop, 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 ow.
Gah. This is ridiculously heavy.
I know, I brought my whole kitchen.
I carried my kitchen all the way here. I can't go anywhere without my pocket kitchen. The fuck is a pocket kitchen?
Your pocket.
You'll see. You know Doctor Strange? I mean, you know Doctor Who in the TARDIS? Yeah, that's what the bag is.
In the bag. It's all the TARDIS.
We got this in the bag. Get it? Because it's in the bag. I carried that all the way here. Again, I said that. Are you impressed?
No!
No, I am Leafy Akaw. No!
This is Patrick.
I see now. Yeah, I'm impressed, Natsuki.
So glad!
It seems like I always underestimated you. You could kick so much ass in martial arts club.
You could so beat me up in playing Mario Kart Wii, bro. You'd be crazy. I can't even imagine how crazy that would be.
Dude, you'd get Shrek'd in Coconut Mall.
You get Shrek'd?
In Coconut Mall.
That's so, no.
That's something I would say.
Shrek'd, yeah. It kind of does.
I'm so down with the memes. I'm so down with the memes. Get it? Because the me and...
I'm going to kill you and strangle your throat while it's out of your body.
Avocado, don't do that!
I'm going to literally kill you!
Let's Peppa do this!
Let's Peppa don't!
I thought of another one, but I forgot it.
I so want to die.
You'll just come to me in the moment.
No.
It's because I'm so small in it! In it? Get it?
What is she, British?
I'm making fun of the British, you jerk. I think it's just a common thing that every country hates British people. Natsuki hits a deaf fist into my chest. You're British, aren't you?
Yeah, I fucking knew it, you're a Brit!
You say bloody hell, do it, say it!
Bloody hell, you fucking wanker.
Bloody hell.
Bloody hell, you fucking wanker.
Aren't you shy, cunt?
That's Australian.
Yeah.
They also say bloody out there, like bloody hell.
Bloody hell.
Bloody fucking hell.
Yeah. Butcher!
Hey. Oi, oi, oi.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Wow. Hey. What?
Your fucking size has nothing to do with it. Do you really hate being small that much?
Well, no. Eh? What the fuck?
What's that supposed to be?
Your boy, you're at.
Your balls are on the floor!
Dude, your balls dropped lower than the friggin' donuts we're about to make. The donut holes we're gonna make. Next. What the? It's not like I hate it.
Oh, yeah, also. Oh, yeah, never mind. Never mind.
I mean, sometimes I like proving people wrong when they think I'm worth my size. It's fun when I get to be so small and also better than other people. I'm definitely lying right now.
No.
because I feel the same way.
Yeah!
I'm like, you know what? Rylan may be taller than me, but he can't animate.
I compensate in other areas. He can't fucking move a model for the life of him.
I may be smaller, but at least I have a bigger dick. That's not true.
Yeah, that's what I like. Are you sure?
I've seen his magnificent cock. The world may never know.
The world will never know how truthful or untruthful. They'll just have to suspect, and we'll keep teasing them.
Dan and Aaron has never seen each other's dicks, but we met in seventh grade, so you could guess.
We were our own Aaron's penis club thing that he had.
We were the D club.
We were our own D club.
Now, if you think about it.
I mean, yeah.
If you truly think back to those days.
Oh, of course, did, yeah. Like, you can't refute it.
Pull out our cocks.
Yeah, and your brother did too. Yeah,
me,
I mean, like.
And Logan.
Yeah.
We were the club.
But I don't think we justified it with, like, the, what's it? Like, the thing of just, like, oh.
Are we gay?
Like, it was just, like, yeah, like, the whole thing is, like, yeah, because we did that makes us less gay or whatever shit like that. Like, it's not,
no,
it's, like.
We just wanted to compare.
Yeah, like, that was what it was. It's just, like.
Because back then, like, sorry for any women watching.
Yeah, all the, or very innocent children, or anybody who thinks well of us and didn't know us beforehand.
If you don't know anything about human anatomy yet in your life, leave this video right now. when you show each other dudes, you just like, all right, I'll whip it out, let's see it. It's usually for one of two reasons. Natsuki, just chill out. It's either to compare sizes,
yep,
or see how much of a bush you have.
Yep, that is very
and
true.
Back then, like, obviously you don't do it anymore because you're like,
no.
I don't want to see your bush. But back then, in like sixth or seventh grade, you're like, oh, it's just coming in.
The only case where, like, I, in the sense, would do it now is that if there was, like, a joke-wise. Because literally while I was at college, I was in Zach and Dustin's room. And then, for whatever reason, we were getting on the topic of, like, oh, so we're talking about, like, butts and stuff like that. And then I, in full confidence, just, like, flashed my ass while I jumped up in the air, and then I, like, and then I pulled back up and acted as if nothing happened, and then I look at Dustin, and he's just, like, full pog face looking at me, and, like, so many other people, like, missed it, and I'm just like, yeah, You missed it. Don't worry.
Oh, pog face.
I mean, he was
in college so far, hasn't, isn't it?
Yeah. That's as far. That's as far, like. I don't think anybody here, unless if I'm like with a person wise or with a lady, I'll get specific. I'm not gay. Anyway.
That's the furthest I've gotten with a lady, but a dude?
A dude?
We've done some stuff.
But!
Anyway, I just realized I never even shared my last poem that I did.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I want to see on that.
Okay, this one. The first one was, I'm going to say... The first one was Monica, like, written like Monica.
Yep.
Like the fireflies remember distant memories, small eyes that flick through the darkness.
And
that's
then the
just
next,
Monica's shit.
And then
right
the
there.
Next one was Sayori.
The next one was Sayori with my cage is precious, my cage welcomes me, my cage is comfy, but my cage is why I cry. This next one is Natsuki, similar. Or written like Natsuki. And
yeah.
The last one is going to be the fucking difficult one, so I better get good words, because I'm doing Yuri. Oh my
yeah.
God.
All right.
Did you... You have the document, right?
I do have the... Let me see that really quick.
Pretty sure you have
Let me just change screen really quick so that I don't expose anything by accident by being dumb. I rather not have, you know, my frickin' your good Doki Doki Doc than right next to A, exposing a whole bunch of future upcoming stuff, and B, also my brain dump, which, I mean, you can't really read when it's that small of size, but...
Yeah.
Where is the Doki Doki?
I should probably change the font to, like,
Doki
not
Doki.
Good, because, you know, Natsuki sucks at...
Right. Sucks. Hers is like almost like Arial, but looks more realistic, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
Okay.
What does that look like?
Nope. Right. I am.
Nope. What does that look like? Nope.
I feel like that one actually is around what she writes in. Not that one. The one before.
Okay.
Let me see.
Not
hang
that.
On. Alright, now go to the... Yeah. What the fuck is that?
I don't know, who cares? We'll just do this one.
Yeah, I feel like this one is around her style. Alright, I am ready.
Okay. This one has a lot of deep meaning, but it...
Yep. It's written in a childish way with having a deep meaning.
It's written in a childish way, but it has a lot of deeper meaning
when
when you...
Look more into it.
Yeah, and I didn't make it as obvious, so... Well, you'll definitely get it, because...
Yeah.
Vanilla ice cream lacks flavor. It doesn't have enough color. Vanilla is normal. I need something more vibrant. Something that will dazzle as I consume it. Chocolate can relate to romance. Pineapple reminds me of a nice tropical vacation. But vanilla goes no further than its color and its taste. Vanilla is normal. I've seen people laugh who eat vanilla. I couldn't do that. Good flavors are hard to find. Everyone I know gets vanilla ice cream. Maybe I have to look in different locations, where people put a little more passion in their preference. No matter what disasters may distract me, no matter how hurt or hungry I am, I will not eat vanilla ice cream. I can't be the only one. Is everybody secretive about their actual taste? Or have they just never tried another kind? Maybe they are scared they won't find another flavor as good. But in my opinion, any other flavor is better than vanilla. Sometimes I feel shiny among the dull, bouncy among the stiff and boring, like I am brimming with more vitality than the rest. That's a bad thing to think, but it gives me vertigo thinking about a life where I like vanilla. Maybe if I liked it, I would sing and laugh with everybody. But to me, vanilla spells defeat. Vanilla is the stem of the rose. Lucky for me, I was born with a distaste for vanilla, and I'm flying past everyone that settles with vanilla.
Yeah, I can read up on that. I can catch its drift. It's really good.
Yeah. Anyways.
another solid one. I'll be sure to also put that in my fucking Discord when time comes.
I don't want to explain any of these to people.
No. Well, me and you could talk about them off camera, but like, yeah.
That's part of the literature club. You guys.
You gotta know the deeper.
On your own.
Yeah. Let you guys make your fan theories about me and Landon's psychology in our expression shit, just like how everyone does whenever Dan and Aaron don't talk for 3 seconds, like, oh my god, they hate each other.
Yeah, but this next poem's gonna be...
Oh yeah, well, it's gonna be very intense.
The most fucking... the best poem anyone's ever heard.
Yeah, well, like, with Yuri, like, it's the most amount of symbolism, and it's always the most intense of the reads, so it'll definitely...
got, like, all the weird... freaking difficult words.
Yep.
Okay.
Alright.
Jeez, never mind! What are you making me say?
I want to just make sure really quickly. Yeah, okay, I am. Cool.
Dude, we've been talking about dicks for a long time.
We were. Well, and then we got into poetry, so I mean...
It went immediately from...
dicks to poetry!
...to poetry to... I feel... like, people are dull and I'm pointy. It's like, nah. Don't think
you can make me talk about weird things just because we're not at school.
No, I was just talking about.
No, we were just talking about showing penises to other guys. Don't worry.
That had nothing to do with you. You don't.
Yeah, you're a bro. I'm wet.
You don't even have a penis to show. Just like.
Yeah, like the cocky, like, pulls down pants for half a second, just like shows, like, what the?
Oh my gosh.
Are we getting started or what? There's a lot of stuff I gotta teach you. What?
I've thought of a funny dick joke.
You wanna
hear it?
Yeah. I don't wanna...
I mean,
it better be funny.
Okay. Here it goes.
So penis walks into a bar.
So one a penis go when penis hide and seek, hide in bush.
Oh my god. That's so dumb. A penis hide and seek, penis hide in bush. My god. I feel like I love how it's like also part.
What I'm talking about.
Yeah, but I like how it's just also like not broken English, but it's just like very simplistic English. When penis hide and seek, penis hide and bush.
When cold weather, better hiding spot.
Yeah, better hiding spot.
Okay, that's a little bit more like you. You're more fun when you just speak your mind like that.
Hey!
It makes me sound mean, and just because it's true doesn't mean you have to point it out.
Now you are treating me like a catch kid child. I was just trying to be a little nicer than you, you know. And just because I don't have a mature and sexy figure like Yuri doesn't mean you shouldn't treat me like a small sexy. I mean,
a small, a little smoky sexy.
No.
I know you hate that, honey.
Oh my god. How does Darude Sandstorm go again? It's because when Aaron does it, the entire thing is the beat drop, but it's like
yeah.
But like, I don't even know why I fucking thought of that.
I don't know either, but I'm down with it.
Natsuki catches her words, and her face turns red.
And then she pulls out.
And she pulls out a gun.
I'm fucking dead.
Well, Natsuki.
Don't shoot me.
Forget it. You're done, Mark.
What the fuck?
My batter gun. I should apologize.
We haven't even started cooking yet.
Nothing even happened yet.
I already have frosting all over me.
It's not frosting. No,
it's not frosting.
But you could lick it off your finger.
We'll take turns.
Ew! No wonder why nobody picked the Natsuki route in case, for whatever reason, it got to points like this.
I mean, we're the ones making the joke. We're the ones, like... I mean,
We're the closest age-acceptable range, and also...
I told you my theory... Sorry, I kept on fucking interrupting you.
Yeah. Keep going.
I thought... Did I tell you my theory on why everybody...
Yes, it's because she's young, and literally every YouTuber is, like, somewhere in their, like, late 20s, early 30s. So, I mean, like, kinda just... Everyone didn't want to get canceled for, you know, oh, it's a pedo or shit, whatever. And it's just like, that's not the point.
Yeah, exactly.
I heard
it. Makes sense.
I mean, yeah, but again, it's just like, it's not...
But then again, if I was back in high school, like a year ago, I would... This is the one I'd go for, so...
Yeah. I would go for Sayori, and I feel like Sayori's like literally like the second youngest of those. And it's not about for young, it's just like personality-wise. Like,
yeah.
If Yuri was to be like, if Natsuki was like Yuri's age or anything like that, then it's just like same deal. It's just personality trait. They had to just distinguish them with multiple different traits. That's how characters work.
Exactly. And I, for some reason, like the characters that say Baka, I hate you. I don't know why.
Kind of like it's a playful, just... like, I hate you, but I also love you. Don't hate me. Come back to me, please.
Like I hate you. It's like I love you, but I won't admit it. Or right. I like you, but I won't admit it.
Exactly. See, that's... I think that you having that trait is, like, the last straw that people will, like not fully know for just, like...
It's funny because I have that trait.
No, that's what I'm saying. But, like, that is the trait that basically... will say for like other people is just like, oh, it's like, bro, they had Bunkatron, they could act so gay. It's like, maybe they are gay. And then it's just like fucking the moment that I would like, if I tried to give you a hug or like even like lightly, like just about to like put my hand on you, be like, stop! It's just like going to like fucking kill me next second.
Yeah, because at one point Maya came down.
Yep.
To give me a hug.
Yep.
For whatever the fucking reason. Women are weird. They just want hugs.
Well, that's the thing is that, like, I'm also very open to hugs. So, like, that's why when she saw me, then, like, we instantly was like, oh, we got hug time. And she was, like,
chasing me around. She's like, I'm not leaving without a hug. And so I'm like, okay, well, I'm not giving you a hug.
You can hug my dead fucking corpse.
And it turned into... us play fighting.
Yep.
I say play fighting because I don't want to be like, it's like, like she tried to hug me. Anyway, now she's covered in a lot of bruises, let's just say.
Yeah, then like, I proceeded to beat the shit out of her, but I'm going to say play fight.
Because if I skipped the ending, that's what it would sound like, because she does have a lot of bruises because she bruises easily. But we were play fighting and... It's fun to fight her because she doesn't, like, Logan, he'll just freaking tackle you. Like, he'll just, like, he doesn't, like, it doesn't matter if there's, like, a nail sticking out of a wall and it's rusty, he'll ram you right into it. Like,
yeah,
just trying to take you down and prove his point or whatever. But, like, for Maya, like, she'll punch you and, like, step back. It's like a boxing match, kind of, but I was kicking more, so, yeah, fuck hugs. I'll beat the shit out of you.
Yeah, see, I know. Don't worry. The only time like you're really is just like you did talk about it where it's just like you enjoy hugs when it's like actually like a long time since you've seen the person. But it's like, if it's just like continuous, then it's just like, okay, I'm going to snap your neck.
Well, I also, like, I would also hug if you almost died. Or I thought you would, like, I don't know. If there was something in my mind that made it a possibility that I'd never be able to hug you in the first place, then I'd hug you.
Yeah. Like, well, because that's the thing is, I did hug you when I got back from, like, the long period of time, like, for when I was up for Fall Court. So it's just like, I know you're in the capability of doing that. It's just like, I feel like you also have a nicer way of doing it. It's because it's almost like you don't want to ruin the purpose of a hug in your mind. Like, because you see it as a way of just, like, a really strong gesture for, like, reunion type stuff, which is a good way of thinking. So it's just like, I feel like that's an understandable way of thinking. Also, you and your brother play fighting a lot, or just wrestling around, like, there would probably be something else there when you, like, raise your hand to you, and then you're about to fucking sock someone.
Yeah, I mean, I like high fives, though. High fives.
Oh, yeah.
High fives are great. Fist bumps are great.
Yeah.
Not a huggy person, but I'm the same way with the I love you word. I'd probably, or
I love you word
phrased fuck off.
So, no, I get you. See, that's how much it's a not uncommon term for you, but just like, not as overused.
Yeah. Like if I was in a relationship, that would definitely be a because there's a lot of people that say it like first month into a relationship. It's not that for me, that word is big.
Yeah, big, oh, it is. Ted Mosby out here doing it on the first day.
Yeah, I know. It's the freaking
love with you.
What?
What? What?
What?
But like, freaking, what was I gonna say?
Something.
Fucking shut. Shut. I'm just sitting here rubbing my eyes, so trying to hope.
Yeah,
it'll
it's kind of hard to do brain. That at the same time.
Anyways,
you're basically touching your brain when you touch your eyes.
Yeah, who fucking cares? Let's just. I appreciate that you were trying to be nicer.
When you touch your eyes, you talk your occipital lobe. Your occipital.
Your hippocampus.
Hippocampus.
I should have been a little more considerate too. But also,
fuck you.
If that's what you're thinking, then you should know that there are tons of guys who are into body types like yours.
Myself included.
I mean I'm into Asian women, so I mean, there's your answer there.
As she looks away dejected, just like, wait, what do you mean by that?
It's because Asians are flat.
Yeah, like screams it in her ear, and she like cartoonically like goes like, in the way of what his scream is going.
Opens the window to your apartment to like scream out to the city. Asians
I like
are
flat.
Flat.
Yeah, Asians are flat.
Yeah. How would you know that anyway?
Well,
just trust me. Gross. Oh, I get it.
Yeah, do you now get it? Do you now? Yeah. Get it?
What? Yeah, you're right. My dad.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
All right. You know, there could be some people that actually care about me, such as my parental figures, like my dad. Oh.
No, I'm Ryan.
Never mind.
My mom, who died at the age of 3. I mean, when I was 3.
I was 3.
What? What are you doing?
Hey.
I said that.
Oh.
You dumb.
I'm just in another world as I'm just still kind of thinking on the events that happened in Zelda.
Oh wow, well, stop.
We need to continue on with the plot. We haven't baked shit yet.
Was that to dad to me?
To
who
me?
Else? Man.
Man.
No, I wasn't talking to any of those. Let's just get started already.
a girl calls you gross.
I feel like anybody would get gross when or sour when they get called sour gross.
I finally found your weakness, Kawa! Don't call me that.
Stop
that
calling me
smells
that.
Deviously.
Spare Please. Me.
I know how he would probably say it if this were a real anime.
How
please
would
spare me.
Please, yeah, please spare me. No!
Wow!
No!
You gotta charge your... Oh.
No!
Well, if Natsuki decides to dish out more insults like that, there's no way in fuck I'm fighting back. Not
I'm
fighting
just gonna
back.
Throw out my fucking house.
You wanna throw down?
You're gonna be fucking homeless!
Fling poop! But she's satisfied enough for now. Finally starting to pull things out of her bag so we can get started. This is a gun!
And then she fucking disappeared.
Before long, the whole kitchen is a mess. What is a mess?
Yeah, spoons, what fucking mess?
Bowls, flour, spilled fluid.
Really?
Bags are strewn about every carrier.
Spilled fluids around the place. Hmm? So you telling me in this area that you play around with spoons, some bras, some cocaine, some liquids, as you call it, cocaine bags. What the fuck
Line
is a strewn?
Up. Yeah, I don't know what the hell is.
I don't strewn. Even know. And you on the countertop?
It's like freaking past tense of thrones.
Strewn is passive for throne.
I don't fucking know. That's what it sounds like.
Stirring in past tense. Strew. Like, if you didn't know it was stirred, it'd be just strewed.
Strewn.
Strewn. I strewned it.
Hey, you think that we should... Oh, I don't think when we strewned those, it was... So when you try to use a big word in a sentence and you don't know what the fuck it is.
Yeah, baby. Why don't you come to the room and we can strewn some,
You want to hear a fancy word, baby? Ammonia Ultra Mic, you're stopping. Still
I'm going to tell you something that's going to blow your mind. Super Califricious.
Hey, baby, this'll turn you on real quick. Peter Pip.
You messing it up at the beginning.
Peter Piper packed to pick a pickled peppers. How'd that do?
Let's check your panties. How wet you went now?
I see a wet spot. Perhaps. Oh,
I think you need a new pair of jeans.
It's because you peed on me because you're scared.
Oh, shit, my pants are down. You right.
Oh, the stream is currently coming out of my penis.
He's still peeing on
At
the
least
pants.
It's perfectly clear. That means I drink a lot of water.
I have good drinking regimen, so
you
it's
You know if your pee is yellow, you're unhealthy.
You are too much soda.
How'd
and...
that do for you?
How'd that do for you?
You just say random weird facts, and you're like, how is it for you?
Yeah, I'm gonna skiddly on daddly out of here, if you don't mind.
Did you know that it's not the entire moon in Ruby that's blown up? When it's a full moon, it looks like a normal moon. How is you doing?
You want to get out of here?
Did you know when you put ice in a hydro flask, it keeps your water cold for about 12 hours? How you doing?
So, can I take your jeans off yet? Just like states the most random thing, and then all of a sudden just like 180 it to just like how clearly you want fucking sex or something like that. You know, I finished all the peas on my plate. I'm a healthy boy.
You know,
so what size cup are you?
Did you know the second president is on the dime?
So,
you sure do got a lot of clothing on.
You know, I put on socks this morning. So, you know. Please let me fuck you!
You like The Office? Let's fuck.
Yeah. See, now that's one that works.
Yeah, that's the only one that works. It's like, you a Pam and Jim ship or a Dwight and Angela ship?
When you said Pam and Jim, I swear I thought you was like, so you like a ham and cheese? I was like, I'm sorry. Yeah, you like, are you more cheese? Of a ham and
Can
cheese
I put
type
my
of guy?
Cheese in your hand.
Oh my god!
I put my cheese in your hands.
Holy shit.
Meanwhile, Natsuki is babysitting all of my movements to make sure I don't mess up on her precious baking.
Make sure I put the cheese in the right hands.
That's not where the cheese goes!
Oh shit, wrong ham! Next thing you know, he's fucking a pig or some shit.
He's like fiddling with his belt like, sorry!
Sorry, I forgot. It was a different pig.
leave Yukawa! Where did you put the food coloring?
Next, well, he just pans at him, he's all blue. He's like, I don't know.
Oh, I thought this was hair dye.
Oh! Oh, that's why it stained so badly.
Oh. That's why it really fucking hurts.
That's why my shit was blue. That's why it hurts.
Man, when I shat basically red hot Cheetos, I really thought I was gonna die there. Yeah. That was my large intestine.
I think I found the hell turd.
Dude. So that's what was birthed of the hell turd.
Bro, that's where babies come from. Buy baby me and then flushes it.
Did you know babies come from red food coloring? Anyway,
let's get these clothes off. Babies come from red food color. Holy shit. Did you know that, did you know that one day that robots will roam the earth and we will all be extinct? Anyway, you know how you make a circle with one hand, a finger with the other? You put them together, me and you, baby girl.
Did you know there's a secret place in Antarctica that I can rub my belly and pat my head? How many buttons are on this?
How many buttons are on this damn shirt? It's so hard to take off.
Do you fucking triple knot your bra or something? Where are the scissors?
Do you know that the Mrs. Buttersworth syrup and the KFC Colonel are a ship? Man, your bra is hard to take off. It's like you're fighting against me.
Did you make this tight for a reason?
Yeah. Man, I'd never seen one with a lock on it before.
Are you writing a book over there? What's up with this?
Oh, that's crazy. You know, there's another pen.
Great, I'm glad to hear.
I could be doing better, though.
I'm gonna have to take a bathroom break. Come back to this.
Alright. Back to the batter.
Back from the bathroom. Hey, you locked the door.
Yeah, hey, did you hear me knocking? Or?
Is that... I know... You turned the music up. Can you,
Yeah.
I know you can. I know you.
I know you're in there. Just let me in. Just come on.
I know you're.
Hello.
I know you're.
Well, meanwhile, it pans the shot. She's already like snuck out the window.
There's just a fucking like long sheet tied together from the
bottom. Yeah, it's on the third floor or some shit. Right?
It just pans to like her. It's like she jumped out the third fucking balcony.
She like has like her clothes like
misconstrued, like, oh, sleeve is off, and then just kind of, like, part of her pants are ripped as she's just running away, screaming for help, and it's just like, hey, just open the door.
You see her panting as she runs into the fucking forest in the middle.
And then she hides behind a tree, and it's just like, then you start hearing, like, whistling, echoing in the forest. It's like, hey, you locked the bathroom and left the window. That's crazy. That's a little funny.
Oh, the shower's going, so you're just taking a shower.
You're just
you?
Wasting water.
Mind if I join you?
We could save water and a good time somewhere else.
Oh, I see you ran off to the forest. Nice place to do. I like your style. Get back here.
Get back here. Yeah, like she's screaming for life and just the most
hard
calm.
To get, I see.
Man, she must really want me.
Man, those cops are getting real close. I wonder what's going on.
Man, I know. Man, I'm hearing dogs barking and shit. And I'm also hearing, this is the police. Please stop and put your hands up. Man, that's crazy.
Man, what did that dog do to deserve that?
Yeah, dude, why that dog off the chain? He's kind of getting closer to me now. Oh, he's not a good boy.
I see that dog is heading straight for something past me, right?
Yeah. Oh, but there must be a barbecue behind me, right? Yeah, that's where it's running to. Man, he barks really loud.
Man.
It appears that this dog can really bite down. Man, it's missing the cookout, man. You know, there are better meats to find than, you know, me.
Oh, man, the culprit has the same name as me? That's...
Yeah, why is the police calling out the name Dennis? That's me, but, I mean, that couldn't be the case.
Hey, officers, I think he went that way.
Why are they consulting a girl named Victoria? The only Victoria around here is the one that ran to the forest. I mean, she's in good hands.
Hey, cops, have you seen a girl run off into the forest recently? I'm trying to track her down.
She looks like business
to do.
She looks like she's in distress, but she's not, I'm telling you.
No, you got the wrong idea. See, I couldn't take her bra off.
She wouldn't let me. I'm innocent. Dennis the man who does not know the fucking definition of about to rape someone. My lord. My god. What's up?
Holy she wouldn't let me.
I'm innocent. I'm fucking losing it. Holy fuck. Oh my god. Oh, that's too good.
The batter's going in the oven soon.
Oh, is it?
Hey, Ruth Takawa. What are you thinking about? Oh, nothing.
Nothing. just a little idea.
just one of four outcomes of this situation.
potentially, what do you do in the bathroom? And, man, I need to put some locks on my window.
I think it's still in the bag next to the table. I know what else is in the bag next to
the
table.
What are you using it for?
What you gonna do with it? To color the banner, of course! I'm making each tray a different color! That way, even if the flavors aren't different, everyone can still pick their favorite!
Oh, I'll pick my favorite, once she stops running in the forest.
Huh, that's a cute idea. Are we doing anything like that with the, icy?
Icy?
Do you want to?
Oh, this is where it all goes down.
You're asking me? I don't really have a preference, so...
Make up your own damn mind!
Come on! You're not putting any heart into this at all! Can't you at least try to have fun?
I'm having fun.
I'm having the time of my life! Can't you tell which fun I'm having?
I gotta go to the bathroom. I peed.
My pants turned brown.
My front turned brown and my... No, my back turned brown and my front turned yellow. I'm having fun.
I'm having the time of my life.
I'm not really sure what Natsuki is trying to get out of me. I know what I'm trying to get in her.
No!
Meanwhile, I see her separate the battle into smaller bowls and put a few drops of cough other color than each.
Yeah.
That does look dope. It's pretty cool.
See? I can be hip with the cupcakes.
I'm just hip with the cupcakes.
See? Let's just forget shut up.
See?
It's not like baking is just about following instructions. You could make your own steps.
Yeah, like chase the girl in the forest. That's not step one, but I mean, I'll take a few steps in the forest.
I don't think these cops are after me, but I'm just gonna hide behind this tree until they pass anyway.
You know what's taking a lot of steps? The dog running towards me.
I'm gonna get a lot of steps in on my Fitbit today. By the time she comes back, man, she's gonna be skinnier than she ever was. I'm not even gonna have to take her off.
It's gonna slide right off.
Slide her boobies right into my hand. Okay, this is stupid. None of this bit anymore.
Dennis is dead.
The presentation is where you get to be creative and have the most fun.
Be fun too. Okay, sorry. I'll just message someone really quick.
I was once a tennis menace. Oh, okay. Fucking.
I was once a tennis menace.
It's a million times more worth it in the end if you're just looking at it and make everyone's eyes lighten up. I like when I make people happy.
Boing! Just flashlights just form from their eyes.
I'm the center of attention. Look at the spotlights.
What? Like the ones you used to know.
Treetops glisten. And children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. What?
I recall Natsuki proudly presenting her cat-shaped cupcakes in Sayori and Monica's delighted expressions.
I recall the memories of it yesterday. Oh shit, I'm living it again.
Flashback, how to get here?
Oh. Where am I? As she's just handing you a cupcake, it's like, shut the fuck up.
There's more girls here. Why do I keep doing
Dennis keeps digging out of his own grave. It's like, you hear him muffled in the grave. You know what else? While his hand reaches out of the ground.
He's like inside of my stomach. He's like, he comes out my mouth. He's like, I wonder if I can.
You see a human outline inside of your stomach. And then when he's like making a point, when he's like pointing his finger, that he pushes it out through your stomach like a cartoon. He's like, oh, you know what else?
You see, like, the imprint of his face in your belly. That's disgusting. Yeah,
that's so disturbing. That reminds me of the fucking gif I sent you. That is like the person that reaches on their crotch and then fucking like splits open their head. It's like, oh, cool.
Yeah.
Well, that's fun.
What anime that was from?
Yeah, I am very intrigued, and that has to be quite a interesting new fear for some people.
Yeah.
Go to your therapist. What do you fear most? The hands going in me, and then my head.
How? It's like it just cuts to the like we only see the hand, but it like cuts to the dude's face, and he's like, "How'd that get in there?
How'd that get in there? I forget the part where that's my problem."
Yeah. Anyway, we should probably do the plot.
Yeah.
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 I agree.
Yeah.
Maybe I will use the food coloring man.
Maybe.
I'm just stalling so we don't have to talk. We have to handle.
Get to that part. Yeah, I know. You're coping with the joke so that it delays the inevitable.
I wish this happened after Sayori died so it could be like the brightening my
a pickup afterwards
instead of this happening right before the shit happens.
Yeah.
Sounds like you're starting to understand.
Maybe I should just like be every single time you just try to start a new bit. I just am quiet and I just let you. You're the only person talking, so that it's just like at a random point I'll just keep on continuing the story and it's just like, nope, you can't delay it. Nope, not happening.
Just make sure you completely finish mixing the ice before you just mess with the food. Yeah, it's getting there. What? I didn't say anything.
I didn't say anything.
We were using the electric mixer for the batter, so I got stuck with a whisk and a huge bowl for the icing.
You're like a man.
I'm eating. I'm so lucky.
You get your present. You finish this damn bagel. You need to freaking stir the batter after I finish this damn donut.
My God.
How the turntables.
Well, yeah.
It's like he's eating the batter. Well, yeah.
Just takes a little longer when I'm consuming it all. It
takes a little longer as I need to eat a few batches of batter first.
Yeah. Jeez, I'll be here all night if you know. Here, look. Natsuki grabs a whisk from me and uses her other hand to tilt the bowl back. Piece of crap, Owen.
See, my dad taught me this one.
After a few seconds, I collapsed.
Bro, after a few beatings for her, oh, dude. Oh, man.
Arm spaghetti. Mom spaghetti.
Natsuki spaghetti. Right? Yeah, every rhyme is just Eminem talking about spaghetti. Spaghetti, 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 yo! Spaghetti, spaghetti, yo!
Summa lama duma lama spaghetti. You assuming I'm spaghetti, what I gotta do to spaghetti?
To get the spaghetti, Eddie, to get this pussy wetty.
Summa lama duma lama, you assuming I'm human, what I gotta do to get out of this spaghetti, got this, get this pussy wetty?
Yeah.
You gotta work it in there somewhere.
Some you have to have wet pussy in there somewhere. you can't not have it. Oh yeah, I got sent something by my dad.
Sami lami dami mommy what?
I got sent something from my dad. It's a TikTok, and he said, "You see this?" So I'm curious. Shut the fuck up! Change to the thing that he sent to me. Shut the fuck up, Taylor Swift!
What are you doing?
TikTok is so fucking gay. Yeah, just open the link.
Open up the safe, hold on.
That's not what he sent.
Wow.
I hate TikTok so fucking much. See, it's nice when you do it in the app and you send it to me, because then it's like, oh, it's right there. But if you send it through iMessenger, it's like, oh, there you go, from Messenger, and then it goes into the thing, and then it shows your For You page, and then like 75% of the time, it doesn't fucking load the video that was sent! Anyway.
you just immediately go back to the story, yeah. So I've assumed you've given up.
Yeah, I don't care, I'll watch it later.
I don't.
My dad sent me something. Cuts to him screaming like a minute later. Oh, I didn't know the situation would get here. Anyway, as if to emphasize, Natsuki sticks a finger in her in the ice and puts it in her mouth.
Right.
I reluctantly start to do the same.
Why would you do that?
Hey! Natsuki suddenly grabs my wrist. You're not allowed to... You gross! I don't want your gross fingers in my icing!
Finger cooties.
Ooh, You're icing, eh?
Be good, little monkey.
Oh, is that what this roleplay is gonna do now?
You sound like you're bow-wowing like a dog.
Are you forgetting who did all the work? The fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, I was about to say, like, what?
You don't even know how to fucking bake. How did you do all the work? I was supporting you the whole freaking time. Emotional support's like the most important one. Have you ever been a CrossFit?
You ever been an animal?
You ever lifted 315 pounds? What does that have to do with baking? It's because I'm stronger than you and I can beat you up.
So shut up. Yeah, that's what I have to say. Fuck you. I'm better.
Agree with me or else. I start to fight back.
Am I able to watch the video now or is it going to take too long?
Okay. There's no fucking way.
What?
There's no fucking way.
There's probably a fucking way.
They're making a Back to the Future 4.
What?
Holy shit! Holy crap. No. No way. No, it's not. It's not real. I know that shot that they used. I know that's not real. I know that's not real. Because...
Screen culture.
Your screen culture.
They use multiple scenes from different things. And one of the shots that they used was... And I know this because I'm a fucking nerd... is that it was from a Lego Dimensions trailer, the Toys to Life Lego thing, and it was a shot of basically him playing Doc Brown. I forget the actor name, but again, he still plays him as, and then he like builds the portal or whatever, like all through Lego, and it's a good ad, but again, that was constructed. That's not real. That's not real. I don't care for that.
I looked it up. It says it certainly is not something that Back to the Future writer Bob Gale wants to see. Which
yep.
With the scribe recently explaining why Back to the Future 4 will likely never happen. We told a complete story with the trilogy, he said back in 2020.
Yeah, I feel like it's good where it left off. I wouldn't mind it, but I just don't. I feel like it would be the same thing as them adding another, like, as they did add another movie to The Matrix, to where it's like, well, it was fine, but it just kind of ruined what it was.
Well,
and two ruined it, and three ruined it.
I just watched the first episode of frickin' that 90s show,
yeah.
Which is the new reboot of
that 70s show,
where Eric has a child, and mm-hmm. So does a lot of the other old cast members, and mm-hmm. The children of the old cast members are the new gang.
Yep.
But I don't like them.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's the same thing as, like, I still haven't even fucking looked into How I Met Your Father, because it's just, like, I don't know how these characters relate, and I don't think they do, so I don't want to give you a chance, because you're probably not funny.
Yeah, and also, How I Met Your Father should have been done immediately following How I Met Your Mother.
Yep, and should have just done the opposite story.
Yeah, exactly.
And it would have been incredible.
Yeah, it would have been the fucking best thing ever.
I would have loved... Because, like, again, in a sense, it's like, oh, but it takes away the mystery. But it's like, no, but it's just like, you kind of also want to know more of her story. Like, you focus so much.
The mystery. We already know how that we the other show ended. So
no, that's what I'm saying. It's just like it takes because like in the first series, the whole thing is like you think, oh, maybe it's this one, maybe it's this one, because he meets like so many new people, and it like, continues off of that. So like then people are like, oh, it takes, but it's like it doesn't matter for that point. Like the mystery of it is like you get to know her more, and then you get to like see more of it. And also, you could actually show more of when they actually had their kids and, like, do a few episodes of that as well. Like, they could have done a lot with an actual sequel to that series that involved her also, perspective.
Not to mention, we know her previous husband died, so we'd probably get to see her previous husband die in the beginning of the show.
Yeah, which would make for an emotional scene as well. Like,
exactly, it'd be like Marshall's dad dying.
It's yeah.
Really, which, by the way, is probably the saddest scene in all of sitcom.
Oh my god, just seeing Marshall is one of like the most upbeat characters and is super happy, and then like to see him like reach that low is just like it was intense. That his show acting, has so many good stuff.
His acting for when he said "I'm not ready for this" was so freaking top notch.
I need to rewatch it. I Met Your Mother again.
Yeah, me too.
It's so
challenge accepted.
Challenge accepted. And suit up!
Suit up!
One of my favorite
things. Five!
You just said that just so, like, properly. Phone five!
Well, that's exactly how he said it.
Yeah.
Phone five!
Hello!
Ron G!
Ron G!
Anyway. Don't make me beat the crap out of you next!
Oh no, the chain continues.
I'd like to see you try. I push harder, just enough for my finger to reach the icing. I triumphantly scoop some with my finger, just as Natsuki tugs with all her might.
Tongue?
The force of Natsuki's pulling me causes me to stumble, making her stumble in turn. Rose! You got it on my face!
Don't worry, I'll get that for you. Just the most rancid lick of all time. Now that's what you call a devious lick.
Whose fault is that? There's a big glob of icing on Atsuki's cheek. I swear if it's white and...
Well, I mean, what color is normally icing? I mean...
Pink.
Yeah, I guess it's true, too. Don't say it! Peter Griffin!
She tries to reach it with her tongue, but it's too far away. I mean, just do the Scooby-Doo thing. Cheese!
eat a whole sandwich in one bite.
And then lick your entire fucking back of your head with, like, all the way around.
And then go, Bree!
Bree!
You sound like you're like you sound like you're Scooby, but he's like more like he's giggling.
Take this. Oh, she's still got some fight left in her.
It's just an anime fight, or it's just all just massively drawn, and they just do the rapid punching.
I like to think, oh, she's still got some fight left in her curb stomps.
Oh, yeah, did I ever tell you about it's the over. Fucking... It's over. It was over before it even began. Did I ever tell you about the time that, an analogy went really far while I was talking with two people here? Because there was a time I was with Jake and Zach, and then... Zach was talking about something that was frustrating him, and then he was like, "Yeah, it makes me want to punch a kid, like as like you know, like that in our eyes is kind of like normal." Uh-huh. And then in comes Jake to add on to that. He's like, "Yeah, it makes you want to curb stomp a baby." And it's just like, "Whoa!" It's like, "Wait a minute." Just went from just like, I feel like it's so funny that we just like, oh yeah, punching a child is normal, and then it's just like, you just change it up just a little bit more, then it's just like, oh, holy shit, that is dark.
I feel like, I feel like you've said curb stomp a baby before, like recently in a stream.
Yeah, I think that is in reference to when he said
that shit is funny.
It's so intense for something so innocent. It's just like, holy shit.
When I think of curb stomp, I think of someone having their head on a curb and then you
like a watermelon.
Yeah, and then you kick their freaking skull into the curb.
Yeah.
You know when someone's on the ground and you're like in GTA and you like kick them?
Yeah, you do that like jump kind of like kick
thing.
Yeah,
that jump thing, but there's a baby on the ground. That's what I think of.
Next thing you know, then it's just a GTA clip where it's someone doing that kind of thing, baby underneath, and it does the thwomp from Mario Bros. Sound, just like, ow! While it steps on.
Yeah, exactly. Holy and then out of nowhere, just a car comes, and suddenly you're flying a million miles in the air, because that's what GTA is like.
Yeah, and then you're just doing cartwheels in the air until you finally land, and you land, like, scratching your arms, and you get up as if it was fucking nothing, and you just walk into your fucking complex.
Or you, land on your feet, and then your character, like, stumbles for, like, 30 seconds before finally falling.
That reminds me of there's a clip of Red Dead Redemption where it's...
Oh my gosh, that game.
There's, like, he's, like, falling out of the sky, and he perfectly lands on a fence to where it fucking just crushes his nuts. But when it, like, zooms out, back out again, then he's just, like, starts, like, walking it off, but, like, in a very obviously uncomfortable, oh shit, and then, like, stops walking and then falls on his face.
Dude, Red Dead, I saw I saw a Red Dead Redemption video of this dude who, like, started talking to a girl.
Uh-huh.
Will started smack talking him, and so you're like, oh, it's an NPC that's smack talking me. I'm just gonna beat the
kill it, or yeah, dude, yeah, make it suffer.
An NPC character. And yep. So since it's like, you know, you just figure you'd beat the shit out of her and then she'd just, you know, fall on the ground.
Uh-huh.
But the woman had some moves, like,
uh-huh,
like a straight up Tekken fighting game. and she was winning at a certain point. Like, there's, like, she would duck under a punch, and then she'd, like, uppercut your face.
Uh-huh.
Or like, come around, like, suplex you. Not actually, but, like, that'd be right. Funny. And then you could... I've never in a video, without seeing someone's face or hearing someone's voice, have I just known instantly how pissed off the player was getting.
Oh, without a doubt.
Because at a certain point, he did... the move that she used where he ducked under,
yep,
and then punched her several times, and then within like 4 seconds of her stumble, within half a millisecond of her stumbling back, he like pulls out a shotgun and then immediately, like, without even thinking, shoots her in the face and then shoots her dead body while it's on the ground.
Yes, like, rapidly, just like, fuck,
honestly,
you,
like, if I had that happen to me, I would definitely get... Because usually what you do is, in GTA or in Red Dead Redemption, you just punch someone until they get knocked out. But to punch someone until they get knocked out and then shoot their body,
yep,
just to make sure, that is an ultimate level of... It's like, not
like,
only am I getting
you,
beaten
I
up by
dead.
An NPC, but a woman NPC.
Yeah, woman NPC.
There's something in a man that's like, no!
No, you're not talking to me that way! I wonder where those urges come from.
Respect to the female who threw hands, though. Holy shit.
Yeah.
Anyway, Natsuki instead wipes it off with her finger before shoving her finger towards my own face. You wish. I'm faster. I'm better.
Yeah, like, yeah. I am better.
I am better.
I am better. I'm smarter. I'm stronger. I'm better. I am better! I like how he's not even saying it to her. This is just him saying it to himself. I'm faster.
This is like the most anime inner monologue thing.
I'm faster.
I'm faster. I can win.
I'm smart.
I grab her wrist with my hand before it reaches my face.
Block.
Natsuki tries to use her other hand to fight back, but I grab that one as well.
I just see just like the slow-mo shot, just like every single time he like does a move and he's narrating, then it's just a slow-mo shot of her other hand coming around. It's like, Natsuki tries to use her other hand to fight back, but I grab that one as well.
She has no more hands left to... Aww.
Yeah,
stop!
See, I told you it's pink. Idiot.
Yeah, it's like a wedge. Yeah, it's literally like white and then red, and it's just like, right, and it's like all pink as well. So it's like, yep, yeah.
Not until you apologize for calling me Grody. Fine, fine.
Grody! I need to be exposed to that word more. It's hilarious. I was just like, did he actually say Grody? He's like, wait, no, he said gross.
No.
This is for you. Better apologize for calling me Grody.
Fine, fine.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry for calling you Grody. You know I didn't mean it. It's just fun seeing you react all pissy with it. You know that has me all tired, but you know, saying dumb things just to get a reaction out of me. You really shouldn't be teasing girls like that.
Why not?
Is that so? In that case, I probably shouldn't do this either. I take Natsuki's finger and put it in my mouth, licking off the icing.
I then proceed to eat the rest of her hand. What?
She takes her hand out. She has four fingers now.
Yeah, she's missing a whole ass fucking finger.
She's like, oh, I need in for seconds. I shove the entire hand in my mouth. Whoa.
It's just a fucking potato. Hand. It's a potato chip sound crunch as he just eats her hand.
You're like, how about this, Natsuki?
Yeah, watch this.
How about this?
Like, half of her body's already in your mouth.
Oh, tasty.
This is fine dining.
Did you seriously just...
Natsuki's so surprised that she can't even finger out how to get mad at me. Anyway, I'm fucked.
Her face is entirely red from the loss of finger blood.
Her face is entirely red. All the blood converges in her face. All the blood converges in my dick.
I'm trying to save it because otherwise it'd be bleeding out.
I gotta put it back in my mouth to stop the bleeding.
Yeah.
And you're just sucking out the blood like a straw.
Yeah, like a vampire with a straw. Just, ah! She's shrieking in pain and you're drinking as if it's like drinking a fucking smoothie.
Bone marrow.
The taste of iron.
I am stronger.
I'm smarter. Better!
Thanks for the blood donation.
Leave Yukawa!
Oh, I've never seen this frame before.
Oh, shit. That look. She's... What?
She's into it.
That's a Yuri face right there.
Holy shit. This line of dialogue is kind of getting to that, too.
You really should do that kind of thing to girls.
That's Yuri's voice.
You really shouldn't do that kind of thing to girls unless you really like them.
You know, it like starts off as like kind of like really, it's just like, you really shouldn't do that thing to girls.
Unless you really like them.
You know that, right?
I like how a specific sound is enough to just make me fucking lose. I just know exactly what you're referencing.
Question is she asking me just like that? How did the mood turn this so quickly?
Proceeds to pull out a book.
It's called,
Natsuki and, Leafy Okawa.
The finger incident?
Yeah. They licked the frosting.
Off the finger.
Off the finger.
Oh, is that like a romance novel?
It's about Leafy Okawa, who's a vampire, and he sucks her blood. What?
Finger.
Fucking kills her.
She fucking dies. She fucking dies.
Is that like the sad part?
It's the solution.
It's usually the finisher.
No, that's the good ending. There are about 20 different versions they released. This is the best one.
So what's the bad ending? Is it, they kiss?
You don't beat the ninjas. The good ending. You fucking drink Natsuki's blood dry through a straw. What's the bad ending? You don't beat the ninjas. It's a array of different endings.
Natsuki gazes at me in silence. I notice her shallow breaths. Why am I starting to feel dizzy? I collapse into her chest.
Yeah. I collapse into her chest while going.
Boob spaghetti.
Boob.
Out of nowhere, the fire alarm starts going off.
You're burning your shit!
The ham!
Don't worry, get the cheese! give me a sec!
It's in!
Yeah. Call me a good boy, I'll come faster!
You like it? You're close!
Holy shit!
Let's clap our hands!
Let's clap our hands, don't worry! I'll get your fucking cheese!
If we clap our hands, the fire will go out! I was making a reference to when in a previous Doki Doki stream.
Yep.
You're like, I think actually was talking about this whole situation where it was, yep. Natsuki was like, and sometimes I role play with my hands, sometimes I'm like, yeah,
oh, harder, you like that, yeah.
But yeah. You started off making the clapping noises and you're like, yeah, that's right. I clap my hands.
Yeah. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, it feels so good. Yeah, I love clapping my hands.
It's such a nice sensation.
Yeah, it really gets me going.
It really takes away from the ultimate silence that consumes my life.
So that's why I keep clapping.
Natsuki rushes over to the oven. No, the turkey. Why the fuck did we put a turkey in there?
Yeah, bro, how did our cupcakes turn into a fucking turkey?
It's not the turkey, it's the baby we curb stomped.
I thought you were just about to end up baby, like, cause like a baby and like they just made a baby. And then it was like, no, it's the baby we curb stomped. I was like, oh yeah, I forgot we said that.
The oven's like, I'm pregnant.
What did you guys get up to get me pregnant?
You must have had a really weird baking battle. Anyway. My name's Dennis.
My name's Dennis, the oven.
Hey, girls.
And guy, you want to turn up the heat?
I'll do it for you.
Tick, 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 tick.
Everything. I like my women with their bangs pressed up against their sweaty forehead.
You can call
like
me
a shower.
You can call me Papa Murphy's, cause I will love you 425 degrees.
But for you, it's Papa Muffy's.
Pop your Muffy's.
I thought you didn't put the cupcakes in yet. No wonder. You left a dirty tray in here, dummy!
Uh-oh.
How could you make a mistake like that? You should have checked before turning the oven on. Don't blame me! How was I at time turning the oven on when I was too busy turning you on? Jeez.
Oh, real. I mean, can't blame her there.
Natsuki uses an oven mitt to grab the blackened tray out of the oven. The oven mitt disintegrates.
And the rest of Natsuki soon follows.
No, my other four fingers! she sets it on top of the stove. In another moment, the fire alarm stops.
I don't think that's quite how it works, but okay. Maybe they're just more advanced, and they actually have ones that turn off after you do that.
Anyway, I'm putting it in me now.
Okay, you ready?
It's gonna get really hot.
I'm gonna slowly sit down on it now.
No.
Here it goes.
There you go. Beep. Beep. Oh, they're done.
The caboose has almost reached the train station.
Choo-choo. You're about to go into the tunnel.
Station. You're the train, by the way.
Yeah. Oh, thank you for spelling that one out. I never would have known.
The Thomas is almost in the tank engine.
Thomas is always in the tank engine.
You ever watch that
just a
show?
Normal fucking train, but all of a sudden Thomas came around and he fucked a train, and then he got a little Thomas inside that tank engine.
How much Thomas do you have in your tank?
Oh my god.
Anyways, the tension from the moment before still lingers over our heads. But the moment has already been lost. I watch as Natsuki slides the cupcake trays into the oven. Then I reluctantly pick up the whisk and continue to with the icing like nothing ever happened. Nothing ever happened.
Oh, everything's perfectly fine now.
Hey, that smells so good. The cupcakes are ready to be pulled out of the oven.
Oh, are they? But the
cupcakes are ready to be pulled out of Dennis.
I thought the cupcakes were marinating in there. I think they could use a little while longer.
Yeah, it's not solid yet, like a brick. You know, hard candy cupcakes.
Yeah.
As soon as Natsuki opens the oven door, a blast of sweet-smelling warm air fills the room. Look how cute they all look, except for yours. Yours suck. She proudly shows off the different food-colored cupcakes in each of the trays. Then I'll look even better once we add the icing.
Yes, you will!
Not like you need to tell me that. I mean, I brought the decorating stuff, so I hope you can get creative with it. Here, scoop the icing out of these bags! Natsuki hands me some plastic bags.
Bags.
Have you ever felt like a plastic bag drifting in the wind?
Through the wind? I ain't there again? You know that there's still a chance for you, and it's getting you. You just gotta shine the light and let it shine. Just own the night, like the 4th of July. Your work!
Is that what?
Yeah, don't you know that that's firework?
What?
You didn't know that was firework?
No! I literally thought it was just some random dude filming a plastic bag and saying, do you ever feel like a plastic bag?
No! Hang on. I'm gonna play it. Shut the fuck up, Kinder Bueno! The TurboTax expert will do your taxes for you. Shut up, TurboTax!
Too hard.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag? Drifting through the wind, wanting to
what?
And then skip forward.
What?
Yep.
Cause baby, you're on fire!
So now you can literally say from that video, because you said, I can't remember the rest of the song, and then you switched it to Shut Up and Dance with Me. So you weren't lying.
Wait. I sung that song back then?
Yeah, way back, because you were singing. You were singing to Onyx, and it was like, baby, you're a firework. Baby, I can't remember the rest of the song. Shut up, fan, dance with me. This moment is my destiny. You said, wow, wow, wow.
I was funny back then.
Oh, dude, fucking, why do you think I watched it that many times?
Yeah, you watch that so often.
I did. Because you were funny when you were like that. You still are funny, obviously, now. But, like, that level of, like, the innocent kind of thing is, like, I feel like
You're cleaning up to steal Onyx's bone.
Yeah. And that shit. Yeah, there's so many different ones. And then the fuck.
I got a question for you.
Do you like waffles? Bad girl, Onyx. Bad girl.
Never mind.
You did not just pee on the carpet. Bad girl. What I end up doing. Never mind.
Oh my gosh. The funny thing is, when I recorded that video, Onyx was like, the fuck did I do? I've been sitting here.
She's like, actually all sad. It's like, oh.
She looked like she did not take me seriously in that video. If I were to say you're a bad girl now, she'd be like, oh, I'm so sorry for what the fuck I did.
I'm so sorry, senpai.
You're right, I pissed on the carpet 3 months ago. Oh.
Even the eye, I pissed on the carpet even though I didn't. I'm sorry. That wasn't that cock.
Like when you think your dog does something stupid and then you're like, oh, you bad dog, your dog will act guilty. Yep. Because he's like, I trust you that I did something bad.
Yeah, like, I actually believe you, because normally...
Yeah.
We give them care and love and food and do all the things, so then right when we actually, like, shift that up, then it's normally like, oh, something happened, it's probably my fault now.
Even if you're wrong, like...
Yep.
The dog still believes...
You did not forget to remind me to pay my taxes! Bad dog!
I put that sticky note on your ear, and you shook it off.
Yeah. You ignored it like little bitch you are, and now you have to pay for it. Fuck you.
It's winter now. Do you want to be homeless?
You want me to take away your fucking doghouse?
I gotta sell you the fucking 2x4s for your doghouse to make money for taxes.
Your taxes.
Anyway. Are you playing a video?
Oh, no, I was watching back to make sure the stream is doing all good still.
Okay. I have these nozzles that will make it look nice and floofy wuffy.
So do I.
I have a nozzle that will make it look fluffy
wuffy. Fluffy wuffy.
This one can even make flowers. We probably won't be using it this time though.
Damn it.
What's this one for?
A surprise.
I picked up one of the nozzles that has a much thinner tip than the others. That's a bomb! Put it down!
That's a bomb!
That one's really as thin, so you can use it to make stripes or other patterns.
So you can make strippers!
I've done that before. Skin-colored cupcakes. It's like... What is skin color? Like,
Are you defining it racistly, or are you being subjective?
There's skin color, and then there's non-white colors.
There's non-white. What the fuck? You see, there's a lot of people, and then there's a lot of other people. So, like, what's the deal with that?
There's other people, then there's the correct people.
Oh my god!
You'll never know.
Yeah, you'll never know what which one you're talking about. So I mean,
I'm talking about Asians.
Yes.
They do everything right. Have you tried their food? Their food? No. Their penises are fine.
The penis, while small, is very effective.
And didn't they trash on their food in that joke?
No. Well, it was saying, dude. It was like, so do they eat normal food? Ha! No, quite the opposite.
Okay, good. At least they, because the food there, it's not only good, it manages to be good, but it also manages to be healthy.
Yeah, it's like, it's not normal, but it's also good. Like, it's good for that, because they're willing to try more things.
What's not normal about rice and noodles?
What's wrong with the noodle? Wait. I gotta play it. Yeah. A minute. Is it this one? No, that's not it. This one.
Quit. Don't quit. Noodle.
Quit. Don't quit. Noodle.
Do or do not. There is no try.
There is no noodle. Noodle. Noodle.
Just putting noodles with random, like, old.
Like, yeah, actually good quotes. I fear the man who has mastered the same as this many times. Noodle.
You think God stays in heaven because he too fears
what he is noodle.
What he has created on
noodle. Trying to think of some other ones.
But you could also use it to write stuff on a khaki.
Ted, noodle.
like happy birthday or whatever.
I'm gonna write fuck Natsuki.
Huh.
And I'm gonna call it what my greatest desire.
I'm going to spell ginger and then rearrange the letters.
And then I'm gonna get Ridgen.
Ridgen?
Yeah! Ridgen!
Yeah!
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 I ended racism.
If we end racism, we should
with Ridgen.
Just take the N-word out, like, just a wipe. If someone has the power to wipe memories, just remove the word, the N-word, that so it never exists. It never existed.
Or just, like, you know, maybe tell the person that thought, it was like, maybe I could own a person, and then you just kind of, like, go back in time, and you just kind of go, like, no.
Yeah, I mean... There's a lot of racist things that happened, like Hitler.
Uh-huh.
America.
Yes, America's history. I feel like that's always the weirdest thing to me, is because it's like, other countries almost act as if it's like, we don't know what we did is bad for, like, they're like, oh, American history is, like, all wrong because they don't actually tell us about all of the, like, bad things. Yes, they do. All the history books do, in fact, mention those parts. Because it's history. It's kind of hard to lie about that when there's so many outer sources and different references for things. We know what we did is bad. Don't worry. Trust us.
You know what it feels like?
What does it feel like?
It feels like... when you just, like, walk up to a person, or in this case, you walk up to a different country.
Yep.
And you're like...
you walk up to a country.
Yeah. You just America walks up to Europe.
America and Europe walk into a bar.
No, because Europe is the same. America, everybody had slaves. I don't get it. Like people had white slaves, too. People had... I'm trying to think of a country that never had slaves, so it's not a hypocritical thing to say.
You know
Mexico,
what I mean?
Whatever.
Yeah, I don't even know. Maybe they had slaves.
America walks up to Mexico, and they're like... Actually, no. In this case, it'd just be America walks up to Africa.
Never.
It's like, ah, I'm sorry, man. Oh, we must... You're racist. Like, oh, I'm sorry, man. It's like, oh, we have to fight back against you. Because you used to be racist. I'm sorry. Yeah, I think we need to cancel this oppression. We need to put more black people in movies. I'm sorry. All right, you know what? Maybe I am racist.
Yeah. Well,
what
you're
doing is we're separating race by I'm so oppressed and you are the bad guy to the point where. We're getting so fed up with saying sorry that we don't even want to say sorry anymore.
Yeah.
We just want to say fuck you.
Stop saying. Yeah. And by the way, as I was looking this up, I'm on Quora, and one of the related things I got is, do Africans deserve any blame for the slave trade? And then just first word, yes. And it's just like, right on. Okay, you do that. You do that.
I'm gonna look up if Mexico had slaves.
Okay. Well, you do that. I'm gonna read for you for a little bit because I want to read. That gives me an idea, actually.
You just be the main character.
Well, it's a literature event, right? We could make it more literature themed by writing a different word on each of the cupcakes. It'd be fun to see people choose their cupcake based on a word they like.
Ah!
Hmm?
I was kind of expecting you to say something really friggin' stupid.
Just for the rest of this episode while we do it, I'm just gonna read the line that says Nagito just for this.
But that's actually... actually a really cute idea, so...
Ah! Maybe I am... I'm getting it from you.
What's that supposed to mean? I'm not cute.
Come on. We're not at school. Nobody's judging. You can't dress and act like this and not expect me to think that you're... not expect me to think you're cute.
Natsuki.
No, I'm... Shush.
I'm sorry,
it's
okay?
It's okay, little baby. Natsuki's voice trails off. Eh?
Oh, what?
Did you say something?
No, my mouth is full. I didn't... Nothing. This is just the icing.
Okay. Natsuki picks up the pace and fastens a nozzle onto each of the bags.
There's a lot to do, so we shouldn't be wasting time. In words. Here, I'll show you how to do it.
Without giving me a chance to think about before, Natsuki quickly moves on. She shows me how to apply the icing, and then we each get to work. Look at all the cupcakes we made. Wow, that was a long and hard amount of cupcakes. When we're finally finished, Natsuki puts them all side by side to admire our work.
Look at how pretty they are together.
Wow, they look like nothing. Oh, you're so cute. Yeah, they are, aren't they?
I was wishing I could have one now.
Well, there's no reason you can't, right? I don't see any harm in that.
As long as you leave an odd number or an even number.
Yeah, otherwise, you're a sinful fuck.
You know, God doesn't like odd numbers.
He doesn't like the odd ones out.
If you die at 31, hell. If you die at 32, hooray.
But what about... Jesus...
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, Jesus died at
33. Damn. Jesus
oh, no.
Died odd numbers.
Yeah, so if you die at even day.
If you die at 32, you're fucked.
You are basically in hell. Don't worry. Right when you get back to that 33, you're golden, buddy.
Lucky for all those abortions. Nero is technically an even...
I want to die.
Oh my god. See, like, if people can do abortions, you can make abortion jokes.
If people can do them.
If people can have abortions, you can make abortion jokes, right? That's how it works.
I feel like this
you can make any joke.
Soon this channel is just going to just be one of those things where it's just like, yeah, this channel itself should be a trigger warning. So just if you're going to be watching... Beware.
I think the fact that we have to, like, just constantly be like, oh, shit, and just, like, oh, that was a joke or whatever. Back then, it would just be like, yeah, abortions are funny. And then we'd move on to the next joke without even talking about it.
Well, yeah, well, I mean, especially back then, because, like, we weren't also, we didn't really talk about, like, on camera much either. Like, that was, like, a thing. But even so, just in general, yeah.
You think that people, if you see them online, shut the fuck up. If you see them online, people. It's very different from, like, seeing them. If someone made, like, a racist joke in person, I feel like someone would be more inclined to be like, oh, yeah, no, it's just...
Time for me to be a social justice warrior, but... Yeah.
But if, like, if someone makes a racist joke on the internet, for some reason, they're suddenly not a human anymore, and their opinion is just, you know... bigger.
I've been looking at the vent thing over the stovetop, and you could kind of see it as if it were, like, indented, and the metal part was, like, going up against the shelf, and then it was slanted, like, going up towards the other shelf. You see what I mean?
Sure.
And then the dark part's the shadow, like, of on the wall.
Sure.
Anyway, yeah, you need to save your appetite.
What are you talking about?
Like, so...
I know what you're looking at.
Yeah, that thing. Okay, so you see the shelf on the left, right?
Yes.
So take the rectangle that's, like,
not slanted in any way. And imagine that instead of it being protruding out, imagine it being like up against the shelf on the side, like up against it. And then instead of the other part being sloped down towards us, instead look along the white edge that's going up as if it was like a thin, like board, like a thin white board, like going up towards the shelf on the right, and then there's like a little flat part where it actually connects, and then if you look then below it,
God, dude,
do you see it?
What the hell is wrong with you?
Do you not see it though?
It's not that it's no, I don't see it, but I also just don't care. You know what you're doing?
Read your line, you idiot.
You're reading too far into just a little, like, it's probably not even a slip-up. It's just a piece of art that somebody
No,
drew.
It's not a slip-up at all. It's just a way of looking at it as a perspective. It's just perception.
You went so far into that.
Because I've been looking at it for so long, so it's just like, no, I have a lot. Because you were reading for two characters, so fucking I had to do something. So I was like, damn, I could... That look, it could be indented. So I just fucking went with that. Read Listen, your line about appetite, you fuckhead.
I was just doing that and then you interrupted me, you bitch. My dad's making dinner tonight, so I really need to save my appetite.
Sora's the exact opposite in that regard. She doesn't have a dad. If she were here, we'd probably be down 10 cupcakes already. And she would still eat dinner.
Come on, that's just unhealthy. Besides, when my dad cooks, I need to eat as much of it as I can. Anyway. I was hoping we would have time for manga, but I need to be home for dinner.
Already? That's a shame.
It's your fault for working slowly.
It's your fault for teaching me like a fucking cook.
You teach me like your wife cheats on you.
Yeah.
You should have thought about that.
Imagine learning, being taught sex from a cook, though. I mean, you could almost see how that would be counterintuitive.
So now what you do is...
You watch, and you wait.
You watch as a dude walks into your wife's room, and you don't do anything about it.
And you just smile and just hope it ends.
And say, I trust her.
I did a sonary, which is basically, for psychology classes, there's also a requirement to do, like, these research kind of survey exam things. And one of them that I looked into was just, like, it was a survey on, like, a relationship. It was like, oh, yeah, there's these two. It's a straight relationship couple. And then, but the girl is open about... like her sexuality to where she'll have sex with other guys and the guy's just fine with it, and then it's just like, now answer these questions. It's just like, would you be comfortable being around these people? I'm like, yeah, I mean, they can do whatever. She's like, would you be comfortable in a relationship like this? Fuck no. Hell no. That's weird. Like, people make your own decisions, but like, in my eyes, it's just like, you know, I feel as though if you're needing more people for that, it's almost an insult to the person you're with that basically says, you're not enough, so I need more than you. Which is an insult. I can't see that as any other way.
It is no other way.
That's kind of straightforward. So if you're
dumb.
If anybody is watching this video and is in that situation and now it's just like, oh, he kind of makes a good point. Congratulations, you're sad, break up with them and find a better relationship. You're welcome.
Or just
coming
be
from a
nickname because it's better.
Yeah, being lonely, it'll do you good for a while.
There's a difference between loneliness and being alone.
Oh yeah. Like,
I can be happy being alone. Most of the time, I can be happy being alone.
Obviously, I can be good for a good amount of time, but I also need from what I've been through, there's a cavity. There. I feel it. It's around.
Yeah.
It lingers.
Yep. But, I have
but it's okay!
Yeah. You know what's annoying?
What's annoying?
Here's another freaking
tangent.
tangent away from I think a lot.
Wow, it's a long tangent.
When I'm on my 30 at work,
yep,
or my 10, who cares, it doesn't matter. Oftentimes I'll just set my phone down,
yep,
and stare in a random location and just think about, yep, like, the world, about
yeah, you were telling about that when you're looking out the window.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And then people who I work with will see me and they'll come up and be like, "Are you okay?" I'm thinking.
Yep.
Like, am I not allowed to? Am I crying right now?
Well, I feel like that's also another thing, is that I would also, like, normally when people are spacing out, it's just like, it's good to just quickly check in. But, like, I feel like it is overgeneralized that a lot of the time when people are spacing out, like, everyone's like, oh no, it's bad. But no, a lot of times, like, for certain people, some people don't even think about anything. It's just like, they're just spaced out.
Yeah, that's more so men, because we don't have any.
We don't continuously worry until we're in a relationship, and then we have to worry.
Yeah, but, like, I realized, I'm like, I don't have anything to do on my phone.
Yep.
I'm just going to, well, I mean, I do, but I could write in.
Yeah.
In Ninjago idea.
I finally wrote another entry today, like, and I haven't done that. Like, I feel like I need to do it more, because, like, I'm now kind of, like, on a monthly basis, and I want to, because there are some positive things that I have to write about as well. It's just that, like, normally whenever, like, something big happens, like, right at a certain moment, that's just like, oh shit, now I want to write about this, because it's that important.
Yeah, I mean, I usually write in my journal either when I feel like it, or when I'm like, oh, because what I did on the 16th was, actually, no, on the 15th, I'm like, oh, it's the beginning of 2023. I should probably just write a entry on the beginning of 2023.
Yeah.
Like, what my life is like and everything that's happening, so that 10 years down the road, I can look back and be like, that's what was going on in 2023.
Yep. That's
interesting.
Yeah. I have some sort of things like that where it's just like, yeah, you're just kind of state of mind. But most of the time, I kind of, because I just retitled mine. Like, I have the Google Doc, like, as the file. It's still filed brain dump. But I just recently retitled it to, because since I'm all into psychology stuff, I just called it the Cognitive Analysis of Ryland Eisenhower. Because that's kind of all it really is to where I really analyze the way I'm thinking about things. And then I still do it in a similar way. And the thing I wrote today, holy shit, it was really long, and I was like, oh, damn.
Yeah.
Maybe I had a lot to talk about.
Yeah, it's usually like that. When you get going, you just, like, come up with other things that you write down and stuff.
Yeah.
Usually, like, when I come into my journal confused,
mm-hmm,
and I, like, write down my thoughts are somehow more easy to process and come up with a solution for.
Yep.
So, usually I just, like, write stuff down, and then I'll realize a contradiction in my writing with, like, my mindset or whatever, and then I'm like, but then there's this, so it's like I'm having a conversation with myself, so anyone would think I'm insane. But
I almost it kind of has to happen. That's somewhat similar along my lines, to where it's just like I'm analyzing myself as if I'm analyzing somebody else.
Yeah, exactly.
Because that's honestly the best way you have to do it, because, like, you have to, like, take an outer perspective more, so that you can almost be comparative to the real world. And I feel like one of the things I can never almost bring myself to do is, obviously, I'll edit grammatical errors, but, like, when I write something out and I feel super passionate and it's just like, no, it doesn't sound right at first, but I was just like, but this is what I typed. Like, this is what my brain was thinking of. There was a line of thought, and it's just like, I feel like I should finish this thought in order to actually look at it and then be curious about what it means when I thought that. But
yeah,
man,
yeah.
As usual, Natsuki places the blame on me.
You can bring the cupcakes tomorrow, Ryan. If you and Sayori each carry some, then you can probably do it in one trip.
Yeah, of course I can do that. And don't worry, I won't let her eat any. I know you're laughing because I know that was a joke. There's no way I could stop this.
I wish she would listen to me the way she listens to you.
Yeah, that would be nice.
She doesn't listen to me.
Yeah.
I told her to live.
Ah, yeah. I again think back to the conversation I had with Sayori earlier today.
I'm going to let you take over this now.
Okay. I felt so helpless. Sayori always does listen to me, but at that point it felt like she couldn't listen to me at all.
Okay, I'm all backed up. Your work today, fellas.
You fellas. I'll walk you out, I guess. Just like that, Natsuki is already about to leave. Fuck! It feels like the afternoon went by in a flash. Oh my god, she's dead!
Yeah, oh my god, she got turned into mush!
Oh, it's just her hand.
I can't stop!
Yeah, dude, that was the first thing you see in the boys. Is
that opens your eyes to, oh, it's this show.
It's a really good way to open and also be like, I'm going to watch the rest of this.
Yep.
But also be like, should I?
Yeah, it's just like you contemplate your morality of watching.
Yeah, it's because, oh my god, here's another tangent.
About the boys.
When I see people on TikTok, there was like a TikTok video of like, oh, this is what an Attack on Titan scene looked like in the anime, and this is what it looks like in the manga. And yep. The manga is always more violent and way more gruesome. The anime, if you remember, is also extremely violent and gruesome.
Mm-hmm.
And there's people who's like, man, I wish they would censor anything. I wish
they didn't censor the puke.
I want to see all the gore and stuff. And yeah, and stuff like that from Chainsaw Man. It's like, why? Is it really better if you see more blood and more
right?
Attack on Titan is already horrifying to watch in a lot of places. What's wrong with your brain? What's wrong with people who like horror?
You're basically asking what's wrong with me.
What's the happiness?
It's not a happiness. It's
dying and
it's the same thing of like when you. Like, how me and you enjoy the whole kind of story in a sense of, like, with Danganronpa, just, like, how it fills you with a lot of despair, and then from it makes you feel hope. It's, like, when you're subjugated to, like...
You don't feel hope in any horror movie.
No, well, that's the thing, is that, well, you... Not during the movie, but you kind of have an appreciation for, it's, like, wow, I'm glad that I'm not in this situation. Like, for when you're young, especially then, it's just, like, wow, this is fucked up, this could happen to me, I'm gonna die... Clowns are gonna be coming out of my closet and underneath my bed, but
scrawny clown snitch.
Scrawny clown snitch. But when it comes down to like other bits, when you're like older, at least for my sake, is that I kind of just more appreciate the level of work that went into like making the scene, like the creator wise, because like. Obviously, if that actually happened in front of me for like for real or any sort of thing like that, it's bad. Just even the act of just like seeing like someone just have like a broken bone, like something like just broken, like it's not a good thing. That's not good. But it's the kind of putting things into perspective to where it's like I can appreciate my life a little bit more in a sense that I'm glad that's not me, I guess you could say, in a way.
Yeah.
And but there are fucked up people that also like really feed off. They're like, yeah, there are some cases of that, but I feel like it's almost for good reason. Cause I'm gonna, do you mind if I spoil something from the Violent Night film thing? The one of Santa where he like just beats up people and kills people. Okay, so I'm gonna spoil. So this is spoilers for Violent Night, but the last scene that happens is that so we see like it's obviously off of Silent Night, and then one of the things that happens in the book is when he like touches his nose, he goes up the chimney. So he's in this like really badass fight with like the main villain at the very end. So we're like going through, and then he gets him like in a headlock,
And then he's like trying to like grasp for air. He's like almost like about to die. And all of a sudden then he touches his nose and he takes him up with the chimney. And then it just right when he gets out through the top, then it's just a burst of blood. It's just like, yeah, because it's like the dude deserved it because he was fucked up. So that's like a different end of the spectrum, I guess you could say. It's all kind of just about just, I don't even know, like the sense of either appreciation, victory, or you're just fucked up and you just like it just for no reason and you just wouldn't actually care if you saw it in real life, which is fucked.
Two ideas.
Yeah, that's the messed up part.
Yeah.
That's where it gets weird.
Can you turn me up on your
screen? Yeah, well, you like went away from your mic or whatever. Like, I was...
What?
I don't know. Like, you were better at first and then, like, you slowly, like, went away almost. I'm gonna turn on the music.
Dang it, you bitch.
Did. And then return. Okay, there you go. I turned you up and I turned on the music a little bit.
Okay, good. Because, yeah. More than that, did I even take the opportunity to get close to her like I wanted? You got pretty close.
Yeah, you literally fucking sucked her finger. I'm just saying, you sucked her finger.
Inside of us, so. Well.
Dennis approves. Don't worry.
Guess this is it.
Yeah. Guess this is it. Yeah.
Pat on well, the back.
So long. I'm about to like do a handshake, and then they hug. I don't want to go.
I'm going this way. My house is this way.
And, oh well, I guess we'll walk a little bit longer together. I guess. So, how was your food? I mean, how? When did you make the weekend?
And then the drone camera zooms off into the air and gets further away. It's like,
yeah, it starts rolling the credits, but you can still hear him fucking up.
Yeah,
I feel like that would be great for an anime outro, is just like it does that and that's just it keeps on fucking up to where you could still hear him messing up as but then it still pans out while like somber music plays.
Yeah. You want to go out on a date?
Do you want to go out on a tomorrow?
Damn it,
I fucked up!
What's wrong with your head? You're so weird right now! Oh,
oh no, it's all ruined my life! Oh no, my life is ruined.
Thanks for all the help and everything!
Yeah, no problem!
I'll see you tomorrow! Wait, Atsuki. What you said before about not always having this chance. It doesn't have to be that way at all. I had fun today. I want to do it again.
I want to do it again.
You showed me how fun baking can be, like you wanted. But aside from that, you can come over anytime, okay? Oh my god, this is hurting my brain because of that freaking Blue Skies mod. I think that's what it
was. The Blue Skies?
Yeah, it's the one where...
Oh, okay, yeah. That's the extra part.
I think that if possible, I'd like to spend more time like this. If you want to read manga or go out somewhere... Oh my god, it's happening!
And then it's about to get ruined! Cause it's also the other thing's also happening.
Shut up. Let me have this. Mm-hmm. Do you really mean that? Atsuki looks at me tensely, like she's trying to hide her expression. Yeah. I want to spend more time with you. Holy shit. Please, Kawa. Oh no. I thought you'd only care about getting this done. Oh. I'm sorry. I have to leave so early today. I really didn't want to. I would really stay here longer if I could, but my dad would beat me.
That's not ideal, you know?
Yeah.
I don't want that.
I'd have to wait for next year's food allowance. I meant to say next week, but next
food
year.
Food allowance.
I feel the same way as you, so.
Whoa.
Oh, God. That Suki suddenly gets closer to me. Wait, Natsuki. Standing inches from me, Natsuki looks up at me.
Okay, this would be a lot more cuter if they actually made the shot where it's like, because since she's a little bit shorter, her like actually looking up at you, that would be fucking adorable. Like, instead of just putting the sprite right here, they could have, it would, yeah.
Yeah, this is for like Monica type stuff. I feel her fingers gently clutch at the sides of my shirt as if holding on to me. Holy crap.
Oh my god.
Her rose-colored cheeks and matching eyes fill my vision, along with her slightly parted lips. Well, glad we couldn't see that in...
Glad that this is not happening.
Form. What is happening? My head starts to go dizzy as I feel her soft breaths against me. What the hell?
I felt it. For a while now.
And it happened.
Natsuki suddenly jumps back. Sayori!
Sayori!
Hi, Leafy Okawa!
Sayori. Just now, we weren't,
It's okay, Leafy Okawa. I just stopped by to say hi.
And now I have my answer. Oh, God.
No.
Well, bye! You should have come a little earlier. I'm already on my way out, so...
Aw, really? That's too bad.
Yeah, well... I'll still see you at the festival tomorrow, so it's fine. Just don't eat any cupcakes before then. Anyway, later!
Clearly frustrated, Natsuki hurries off and Sayori waves goodbye. She never got the kiss.
Aww.
Oh, God. I'm turning down them. I have it muted, dumbass. We've done
this. Oh, you can mute. I need it for the stream. And you're loud again, which is a thing.
I am? How do you know?
Because you said I can also turn you up more again. There.
I mean, you're loud, maybe. Maybe that's the thing. Maybe you're just loud.
I don't think so. On stream... Oh, that might be true, too, actually. That's just all of game audio. I'll turn myself down a little bit. Okay. Cool.
Well, fine, I'll put the music back on. Fuck. Sayori, I thought you didn't want to come over today.
Well, I tried staying in my room, but my imagination was being really mean to me.
You have one of those?
You can make pictures? You don't have aphantasia?
So I had to come here to see it for myself.
See what? What are you talking about?
You know, how much fun you were having with Natsuki. And how close you got to her. It makes me really happy that you made such good friends. That's all that matters to me.
Tears start to fall down Sayori's face.
That's all that matters to me. Why am I feeling this way, Leafy Okawa? I'm supposed to be happy for you. Why does it feel like my heart is splitting in half? It hurts so much. Everything hurts so much. This would be so much better if I could just disappear.
Sayori, don't say that.
Holy shit. What the fuck?
What happened? What's going on? A distraction?
No.
For my happiness? No. Stay alive?
Fucking bimbos banging on my door.
Really?
Yes! There are two girls that are banging. I was like, hey, is Raf? You're like, no! Yeah, as they also see Doki Doki on the screen as well. I'm in the middle of something! Get the fuck out!
Whoa, Raph's gone! I'm doing something!
I'm in the middle of something, you bitch!
Oh, okay.
Alright.
cool.
It's truly Fiokawa. If I wasn't here, then you wouldn't have to waste your sympathy on me. You wouldn't have to put up with me being selfish. Monica was right. I should just...
So she actually just straight up said it.
Yes. She literally told her to kill herself.
Wow.
Yep.
And you like just let that slide? You're just like, yeah, I'll think about it.
I was like, man, that's an option, man. Oh, that's, wow. Okay.
Anyway, Monica? Monica was right about what? Sayori. What I said before is true. I'm not going to let this continue. Caring about you like this isn't the burden your mind is making it out to be. It's something that makes me happy. It's something that I wouldn't trade for anything else. So even if it takes an entire lifetime, I'm going to be by your side until you don't feel any more pain.
But...
Sayori looks away. I put a hand on her shoulder to reassure her.
I'm scared, Leafy Okawa. I'm really scared.
What are you scared of, Sayori?
I'm scared that I might like you more than you like me.
Sayori.
It's true, isn't it? I was weak and started to like you too much. I did this to myself. Leave you, Okawa. I like you so much that I want to die. That's how I feel.
Okay.
And...
That's enough, Sayori. I don't want you to hurt anymore. I slid my hand down Sayori's arm and squeezed her hand in my own. Well, great. Do you remember how I said I always know what's best for you? You still believe me? Wordlessly, Sayori nods. Even if you don't understand all of your own feelings, I know what you need the most right now. And that's what I'm gonna give you. Great.
Yep.
Oh, God. Fuck. Next time on Game Grumps.
Yeah, do you want to?
No.
Do you want to just get it over with and get it done?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna do it.
Okay.
All right. Well, here's the thing is, like, I feel like it's not even just really the option of this. It's like the way he handles how he says these as a whole. That's the problem.
That's true. No matter what you do.
Mm-hmm. But what would you say in the situation? if you were right in Leaf Yokawa's shoes.
You think that's easy?
No, not at all.
You'll always be my dearest friend.
Is that what you're going with?
Yep.
Okay.
You'll always be my dearest friend. What you need most is for things to be like they've always been. Monica told me the truth. She told me how much happier you seemed after I joined the club. I know you're struggling with some really difficult feelings right now. But... Please trust me that I know what's best, and what will make you happy in the end. I promise I'll help get things back to the way they were.
I'm gonna need to turn down again a little bit. Because you're quiet a little bit again, though.
I see.
Sayori forces a smile through an incredibly pained expression.
Is this what it feels like? To get... stabbed in the chest. I should write a poem about this.
Sayori?
It's okay. This is just my punishment, remember? For being so selfish. So please, Please don't worry about these stupid feelings. I know you're right. I knew this whole time that there's no happiness down that path. That's why I came here. Just so I could get the answer I needed to hear. And the other thing, you're also right that I just wanted to go back to the way it was. I realize that now. You really do know me better than anyone, Leaf Yokawa. I'll trust you with anything. Anything at all. So.
Sayori's smile finally breaks. All of a sudden, she turns around and drops to her knees. Clutching her head with both hands, she screams as loudly as she can. I'm so shocked that I don't even know how to react. Sayori looks over her shoulder and flashes one more time before turning around and running off.
I got to see two titties before she ran.
Oh god, Sayori! Oh, Lord. I'm left helplessly standing in the front of my house. Why am I feeling so horrible about this? There's nothing more that I could have done. The most I can do is support Sayori through her feelings and help her on the path that's right. But I'm having as much trouble understanding Sayori's feelings as she is. Even though I can comfort her, I keep wondering if I should be doing something more or something different. I know these thoughts will continue to plague me until things are back to the way they were. I'm going to give it everything I've got. Sayori will always be my dearest friend. And I'll do whatever it takes to put a smile on her face every day.
Mm.
Okay. Time to block her out of my mind for all eternity now.
Uh-huh.
It's the day of the festival. Of all days, I expected this to be the one where I'd be walking to school with Sayori. But Sayori isn't answering her phone. I considered going to her house to wake her up, but decided that's a little too much. Meanwhile, the preparations for the event should be nearing complete. I managed to carry all the cupcakes myself by carefully stacking two trays. Natsuki is already texting up a storm with lots of emojis, but I can't respond thanks to my hands being full.
Mm-hmm.
Funnily enough, I probably feel the same way as Natsuki about the event. I'm more excited for it to be over so I could spend time with Sayori and Natsuki at the festival. Not Yuri and Monica, though.
Yep.
But knowing Monica, I'm sure the event will be great, too.
Wait, hang on.
Leaf Yokawa! You're the first one here! Thank you for being early.
That's funny. I thought at least Yuri would be here by now. Monica is placing little booklets on each of the desks in the classroom. Please, music start.
Nope.
They must be the only prepared to have all the poems we're performing.
The music does not cut in until it happens.
In the end, I found a random poem online that I thought Monica would like and submitted it. So that's the one I'll be performing.
Lazy as shit. It was like, yeah, I fucking just saw one online. I was like, yeah, this will do.
I'm surprised you didn't
once
bring
upon a midnight dreary. While I wandered, weak and weary.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you didn't bring Sayori with you.
Yeah. You sure are.
Yeah, you are very surprised, aren't you?
Yeah. She overslept again.
Hang on, wait. I'll make the joke later.
That dummy. You'd think that on days this important, she'd try a little harder. I say that, but I suddenly remember what Sayori told me yesterday. I then think of myself as a dick.
And that was and then I remember that she literally screamed out loud in the most gut-wrenching pain way. And then just walked away smiling. So, you know, there's almost like a little bit of a red flag right there.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, Monica, you said that's something to Sayori, and she said that that you were right.
That you're right about it, yeah. And she's like over the corner like, yes!
She's like, me, Joey, the chair. It's new. Just got it.
New replacement. I mean, not replace. I mean, isn't that a nice chair?
And I suddenly feel awful knowing it's not nearly that simple for her. I only said it because it's the way I'm used to thinking. But maybe I should have gone to wake her up after all.
You should take a little responsibility for her, Leaf Yokawa.
You should shut the fuck up.
Get your fucking pussy scrambled. I mean, especially after your exchange with her.
Oh my god. She even fucking knew that too.
You kind of left her hanging this morning, you know?
Exchange? Monica, you know about that? The whole school knows
about it.
Of course I do. I'm the club president after all.
But I stammer embarrassed. Did Sawyer really tell her about it that quickly? Or was Natsuki hiding behind a bush watching the whole thing go down?
Yeah, and then she was the one that told you.
About how I basically turned down her confession. That makes me really seem like the bad guy here. But I'm the one who knows what's best for her, right? No.
No.
Only God does.
Yeah.
Jeez. You don't know what the full story at all, so.
Don't worry. I probably know a lot more than you think.
The beginning.
Yep.
It's starting.
Her self-awareness is really showing.
Monica's being as friendly as usual, but for some reason I felt like a chill down my spine after hearing that. Glad to hear you're self-aware of her self-awareness.
Do you want
to
check out the pamphlets? They came out really nice.
Yeah, sure.
Can't wait to see what Sayori wrote.
I grabbed one of the pamphlets laid out on the desk. Oh yeah, they really did. What is this one?
Yeah, this one looks a little funky. Man, they wrote a lot.
Hmm. What head? Whose head? Signed Sayori. Oh.
Oh shit!
Bottle caps! Something like this will always definitely help people take the club more seriously.
Yeah, I thought so too.
I flipped through the pages. Mom's spaghetti.
Great poem.
Each member's poem is neatly printed on its own page, giving it an almost professional feel. I recognize Natsuki's and Yuri's poems from the ones they performed during our practice. What's this? I flipped to Sayori's poem. It's different from the ones she'd practiced. It's one that I haven't read before.
Get out of my head, 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 get out of my head. Get out of my head before I do what I know is best for you. Get out of my head before I listen to everything she said to me. Get out of my head before I show you how much I love you. Get out of my head before I finish writing this poem. But a poem never is actually finished. It just stops moving.
What is this? Reading the poem, I get a pit in my stomach.
Leaf Yokawa, what's wrong?
Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
This poem feels completely different from everything else Sayori's written. But more than that, I changed my mind. I'm gonna go get Sayori, so...
Well, all right.
Good luck with that.
Try not to take too long, okay?
Easy for you to say. I quickly leave the classroom.
Don't strain yourself.
I'll strain your blood out of you.
Strangle the wind out of your fucking throat.
Her saying that pisses me off.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, she fucking knows what she did. Like, oh, she's very cocky about it.
But then again...
She's self-aware. None of the other ones were, I mean...
Yeah, like, she sees everybody as fake video games.
But she's being playful about it, which kind of just fucks it up.
I know, but, like... but like I would do the same thing.
Right.
Or I'd kill all my friends if I was self-aware and they were fake. Like, okay, imagine if you were in a coma dream, and the only way to wake up from the coma dream is to make it so fucked up and try and force your brain to get it through to your head that none of this is real. So your best friend's like, oh, hey, come over again. And then you're like, okay, I will. And then you stab him in the face. And then your parents are like, oh, yeah, you come down to eat dinner. You stab them in the face. You kill everybody in your coma dream until you realize, until your brain starts to finally wake up and realize none of this is normal.
Nope.
Get out. Wake up. Get out. Kill everybody in your coma dream.
Just find a way.
That's the only way you escape.
Find a way out and find something that's real.
Don't let the coma dream, like, don't give the, because there's like a whole routine that happens in it. If you stick to the routine and you're like, you feel like everything is real in there, you have to, anyway, whatever. At least, I mean, not like I know anything about comas. But I think that's a dope thing for a story, so whatever.
Oh, right.
I quicken my pace. Mom's mace. What was I thinking? I should have tried a little bit harder for Sayori. But it's not a big deal to at least wait for her or help her wake up. Even the simple gesture of walking her to school makes her really happy. Besides, I told her yesterday that things will be the same as they always have been. That's all she needs. And what I want to give her. I reach Sayori's house and knock on the door. I don't expect an answer since she's not picking up her phone either. Like yesterday, I opened the door and let myself in. Sayori? She really is a heavy sleeper. I swallow. I can't believe I ended up doing this after all.
That's your reaction to now being in this point in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, it truly is.
Yeah, like, when you're just like, yeah, I was playing through Doki Doki, and just kind of like, after so long, it's like, yeah, we made a whole bunch of jokes, and then now it's just like, oh, we're here now.
Yeah.
It's happening.
And I didn't think it would hit me this hard again.
Yeah.
Waking her up in her own house. Isn't that more like something a boyfriend would do? In any case, it just feels right. Outside Sayori's room, I knock on her door. Sayori, wake up, dummy. There's no response. I really didn't want to have to enter her room like this. Isn't it kind of a breach of privacy?
Take it from my perspective, I'm the one that's in control of it, and it's just like, I just hate clicking, getting closer to this.
Yeah. But she really leaves me no choice. I gently open the door.
Yeah. Yeah, it's always a great sight.
Did Dan Salvato put his name there?
Yeah, he put all sorts of stuff right, yeah. Just as disturbing the second time I played it through.
Believe it or not, I take a lot of inspiration from Dan Salvato when thinking about music.
Oh, right. Like, I mean, the way that he did, like, these pieces for it is just, like, it's so eerie and impactful.
I heard him talk about the process of this game.
Yep.
When, like, he had, like,
3 or so Twitch live streams where he played this game and talked about it. And he talked about his process of coming up with the music.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't remember exactly what it was, but I remember it being a very fascinating story. Yep. Especially at that time, I wasn't really that into music. Mm-hmm. I don't remember if I was even taking piano lessons at that time.
Right.
And it fascinated me. And now, music is like a very big factor in changing my mood.
Yeah.
And what's funny is, even like when I'm scrolling through TikTok and stuff, I'll find funny videos, I'll laugh, but then I'll find a video that has like music that I'm like, oh, I like something in my brain just like likes the music, and it just immediately, I set my phone down, I just have to go to the piano and just play something similar to that.
Yep.
It's like, I don't know, it just, the mood for music just hits me like a truck, and I just end up having to go.
Oh, right. It completely encapsulates you in whatever your experience is, to where I talk about it, like, when it comes down to, like, even, like, whatever videos I'm making is just, like, just having something in the background to also kind of, like, help. It helps the mind not wander, to where it's just, like, if you want to have your mind wander, it's like, oh, I want to listen for something else. And then it's just music that is being played through what is being shown. It will instantly re-grab your attention. It's almost like a reset. It's like, bam, you're right back in the video. Bam, you're right back in the video. To where it's just like, you can't stop at that point.
Yeah.
It's just that disturbing at times of how much it can work.
Anyway, I suppose I'm just coping.
Yeah, just trying to find a thing to talk about for.
Anyway. What the hell? Is this a nightmare? It has to be. This isn't real. There's no way this can be real. Sayori wouldn't do this. Everything was normal up until a few days ago. That's why I can't believe what my eyes are showing me. I suppressed the urge to vomit. Just yesterday, I told Sayori I would be there for her. I told her I know what's best, that everything will be okay. Then why? Why would she do this? How could I be so helpless? What did I do wrong? Turning down her confession? It has to have been what pushed her over the edge.
You know, it's also a big thing that I feel like a lot of players probably felt even worse about is that they might have thought, because like, when they like did their initial playthrough and they got those two options, they probably thought, because they wrote out two different things that they say right here, that's the reason why she killed herself, to where they think, oh shit, I should have picked the other one and then I could have prevented this, but that's not the case.
You know what that is? That's bargaining.
Yep.
I love thinking about the five stages of grief.
Yep.
And how it's always true.
Oh yeah.
Like it's always exactly how it goes. It's interesting. Yep.
Yeah, it can go out of order, but like no matter what, you will go through all of them, and then it could be out of order, but most of the time it does go in the stated order. But yeah, it's just crazy.
Her agonized scream still echoes in my ears. Why did I do that to her when she needed me the most? Why was I so selfish? This is my fault. My swarming thoughts keep telling me everything I could have done to prevent this. If I just spent more time with her, walked her to school, and gave her what I know she wanted out of our relationship. And I could have prevented this. I know I could have prevented this. Screw the literature club. Screw the festival. I just lost my best friend. Someone I grew up with. She's gone forever now. nothing I can do to bring her back. This isn't some game where I can reset and try something different. I had only one chance, and I wasn't careful enough. And now I'll carry this guilt with me until I die. Nothing in my life is worth more than hers. But I still couldn't do what she needed from me. And now, I can never take it back. Never.
I didn't have a save there!
Never. 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 Never.
And
ends part one. Right on! Right on!
And that is where we are going to end off. And yeah, experiencing that all over again, holy shit. Yeah, still fucked. Still a lot. Not good. Not good of a feeling at all. And never will. Ever.
Yeah.
And that's where we're going to leave you guys off. So hope you guys, you enjoyed the beginning part of the stream at least. You know, other part, eh, you know, take it as you will. And we will see you guys in another time. Peace out. And bye.